Dear friends, in class 9 we have studied 7 chapter triangles, and in this we have already studied if all three sides of a triangle are equal, that is all three sides are equal, then we call such a triangle as equilateral triangle. If two sides are equal or it is like this, if two sides are equal, then we call such triangles as isosceles triangles. And if none of the side is equal, that is one is smaller, second is little bigger, third is more bigger, then please note all three sides are different. In this we call it a scalene triangles. All three sides are different. Dear friends, we have one theorem related to isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle means a triangle which is having two sides equal. So let us consider one of the triangle as isosceles triangle. Here let ABC be an isosceles triangle. What is given? Angles opposite to equal sides of an isosceles triangle are equal. So we are given that triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. We are given triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle in which equal sides are AB and AC. That is AB is equal to AC. This is what is given to us. What is asked to prove? Angles opposite to equal sides. So angles opposite to equal sides are angle B and angle C. So we are asked to prove that angle B is equal to angle C. So I hope everybody understood the statement. Angles opposite to equal sides of an isosceles triangle are equal. This is what we need to prove. Now for this we need a construction. Draw angle bisector of angle A. Draw angle bisector AD at vertex A, at angle A. So we will get AD is the angle bisector. It means it divides this angle A into equal parts. So AD is the angle bisector of total angle BAC. I will write here BAC. The reason is there are three angles at vertex A. Now how to solve this? Consider triangle. In order to solve, proof. We consider triangle BAD and CAD. BAD and triangle CAD. Consider these two triangles separately. In this, AB is equal to AC. This is given to us. We are given that two sides are equal, and we are given that AB is equal to AC. This is given to us. Then AD is a common side, so AD is equal to AD. Now we have got two sides equal. We have also got angle BAD is equal to CAD. Angle BAD is equal to angle CAD. Reason is AD is bisector means it makes two equal parts of angle. Bisector of angle BAC. So please note, it means that these two triangles are congruent by SAS. Angle is included by the two congruent sides. So here we can say that triangle BAD is congruent to triangle CAD by SAS test. As told earlier, we need one-to-one correspondence, and it is very important. Here please note, we start with angle A. So angle A is congruent to angle A, means A corresponds to A. Now in this, we have already written A corresponds to A. It means B corresponds to C. We have already written A corresponds to A, means D corresponds to D. So we will get BAD, that is second vertex, first vertex and third vertex. Here also we will write the same, second vertex, first vertex and third vertex. So we will get BAD is congruent to triangle CAD by SAS test of congruency. Now see, if two triangles are congruent, it means if we keep this triangle on this, they will exactly coincide with each other. That is, first angle is congruent to first angle, second angle is congruent to second angle, third angle is congruent to third angle. It means angle B is congruent to angle C. Reason is, they are corresponding angles of congruent angles. So thus, in this way we can show that angle B is congruent to angle C. Hence, from this we understand that if in isosceles triangle, if two sides are congruent, then angles opposite to them are also congruent to each other. Dear friends, next is theorem 7.3. We have the sides opposite to equal angles of a triangle are equal. It means we are given in a triangle two angles are equal, and we have to prove that these sides are congruent. So let us consider a triangle ABC in which two angles are congruent. So we are given that in triangle ABC, angle B is equal to angle C. This is given to us. That is, two angles are equal angles, and we have to prove that side opposite to them, side opposite to angle B is AC, and side opposite to angle C is AB. We have to prove AB is equal to AC. So for this also, this is given to us, angles are congruent, and we have to prove that these sides are congruent. Now please note, here also we need to do the construction. So we are going to construct AD angle bisector. AD is the angle bisector of angle BAC. So if you construct AD as an angle bisector, it means we are going to get these two angles congruent. So please note, here AD is the common side, then BAD and CAD are congruent to each other because that is our construction. Then angle B is congruent to angle C. So if you keep these angles one above the other, these triangles one above the other, they will exactly match. That is, these two triangles are congruent. And if the triangles are congruent, then we can say that their corresponding sides are congruent. So in this way we are going to prove. So let us prove it. For this we need to construct. Construction is, construct angle bisector AD, construct AD as angle bisector, AD as angle bisector of angle BAC. So AD is the angle bisector. Now if AD is the angle bisector, it means proof. So before this, we are going to consider triangle BAD and CAD again. Consider triangles BAD and triangle CAD. So here we will get angle BAD is congruent to angle CAD because that is our construction. Then angle B is equal to angle C. This is given to us. Then AD is equal to AD. That is common side. Now please note, two angles and one of the side is congruent. It means two triangles are congruent by AAS test. That is, two angles and side test. Now here one-to-one correspondence is very important, and one-to-one correspondence can be written from angles directly. So please note, here angle B corresponds to C, then A corresponds to A, A corresponds to A, it means D corresponds to D. So we can say that triangle BAD, I have taken the names from top to bottom, so this side also they will be from top to bottom, is congruent to triangle CAD. Reason is two angles and side test, angle angle side test of congruency. So two triangles are congruent, it means if you keep B on C, A on A and D on D, those two triangles will exactly coincide with each other. It means this side formed by first two vertices is equal to side formed by the other two vertices. It means AB is equal to AC. Therefore, AB is equal to AC. And reason is, it is they are the corresponding sides of congruent triangles. Thus, we can say that if two angles are in a triangle, if two angles are congruent, then sides opposite to those congruent angles are congruent.